anyway, we had the special magical glass that helped go into this device that let them see up to Ruidus, and you guys looked through and saw a city.
Yes, more
and
of that,
woven,
please.
And a woven net of magic.
It was holding something in or keeping something out.
One or the other, that would be divine lattice work. Okay, okay, all right. This is, I'm pleased that we didn't find ourselves completely impeded by dullards. This is delightful. All right.
By chance, that text that you've read from Vassalon.
Oh, I won't take that away. Please, Dr. Baron. Yes, of course. So within these tomes, some of the oldest that exist on Exandria, if not the oldest books on record. First off, they speak of two deities that have been forgotten by history, that existed in the Pantheon long ago. One is referred to as Ethadoc.
Oh, we got names!
The Endless Shadow.
Ethadoc.
I'm spelling that wrong.
E-T-H-E-D-O-K.
Damn.
Endless.
E-D.
Shadow.
The Endless Shadow. And Vordo, the Fate Shaper.
Vordo.
The Fate Shaper?
An A or an O?
Vordo.
Voldo.
V-O-R-D-O.
Oh, Vordo.
Two.
Vordo, the, what was it again?
The Fate Shaper.
Fate Shaper.
Ethadoc oversaw the certain gods have different focuses, different realms that they put their will over and guide and shape within all of Exandria's unique weave of power and influence. Ethadoc was the god of darkness and winter, and Vordo was the god of fate and order. Now that was already disconcerting enough, but this historical text also gave proof that Ruidus didn't exist for a time. And it's not that it didn't just not exist, but it was created by the gods. The texts speak of an era during the founding where the gods showed fear. Something from beyond the stars that they recognized arrived here. And they called it Predathos.
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 This Predathos resisted their miracles and hunted them.
Oh fuck, oh fuck.
Spawning its own twisted life in its wake as it did.
Wait, Predathos was one entity or was it several?
As far as the texts go, I have no confirmation. But it is said that it devoured Ethadoc.
Oh.
And then Vordo.
Oh.
It's a god eater?
The texts then speak of an accord between the gods and the primordial titans to carve a prison from Exandria itself. To steal away Predathos and send it away into the endless darkness above. It seems the prison, however, clung to our world and hung in the sky. There's a new moon. Our theory is that in attempting to erase this known history surrounding this prison with an air of superstition and cursed tidings, it would dodge enough interest to ever really become a danger again. That has worked for eons to their credit. However, I would be inclined to let this sit, if it means the safety of all, if it weren't for this growing rise in Ruidus flare activity that they've been studying. It leads me to believe that something is about to happen. Attempts to bring this to the attention of the High Bearers and the top clerics and priests, whatever they call themselves, have been met with extreme prejudice, denial, and now moves to silence us. They fear what we know almost as much as they fear losing the faith of their followers, their societies. So, this is what we know, and this is what you now know as well. Congratulations, you're tethered to cursed knowledge with us.